Saying to YouTube, we are the sole proprietors. As y'all might already know, I am your boy Dayron Alexander the Great. To my right is my big boy
Kendrick. It sucks that we actually recorded. This is our second time recording. It's the first time we're recording in slow mo. That's funny. I just found it funny. That's why I had to bring it up. But man, if you like this video, leave us a like, comment,
subscribe.
Please subscribe. Share this video with your pupils. Follow us on social media, Instagram, at the Sole Proprietors, Twitter, Sole Proprietors, and let's dig right into it.
With a Z.
Let's dig right into it. What we got?
We got something pretty cool for y'all today. Nothing exactly new because it is a re-release, as y'all might know.
For sure.
But a Zebra Yeezy 350 V2. My favorite. I actually like the V2 more than the V1, just to throw that in there.
Mm-hmm.
But Kenny Delafell.
Go ahead and give them the specs.
Go ahead and give them the specs.
All right, just a quick rundown, man. You got the 3-layer prime knit upper.
Of course.
You got the paintbrush style white stripe with SPLY 350 across the lateral side.
Of course.
SPLY supply, St. Pablo loves you, whatever.
Either way, it looks good.
You got the heel tab with the matching black stripe through the center.
Mm-hmm.
3M, three-stripe branding in the back liner.
Three of them.
3M.
Three.
A milky,
milky
cookies and cream,
cookies and cream,
translucent outsole,
translucent,
and the ever so eloquently Boost Technology midsole
peeking
out of the caged outsole as if it is a bird peeking out of its nest.
You heard me?
You heard me.
Do you hear me?
You heard me.
I like that look. I like that touch you put on. That.
You like that?
That was,
that was beautiful.
Nice.
I know, man.
That was perfectly orchestrated.
That was, thank you.
But, anyways. Just to give y'all my thoughts on this shoe, man, something that I noticed right before we hit record on this video is that this shoe ain't white. It's white, yeah, but it's actually cream. What is white on this shoe is this stripe with the Supply 350 on it, or SPLY 350 on it.
Yeah.
I didn't know that.
I didn't
know. But I actually liked it, you know? Like I said, I rock with the whole, this ain't sale, but I rock with the whole off-white color.
Indeed.
You know, and instead of it just being white, I like that. Vanilla. What word am I trying to say? Vintage cream. Look, you feel me?
Right on.
What you think about it, kid?
Beautiful, man. This was as far as all Yeezys, whether it be 350, V1, V2, 700, 750, 500.
1, 2, 3, 4.
This is the absolute. This, for me, this and the bread are the absolute grails to me as far as Yeezys are concerned.
Mine's are semi-frozen, copper, and green.
These are an absolute grail along with the bread. V2 fits my foot better.
Mm-hmm.
You know, of course, I do love comfort as far as my sneakers are concerned. This upper is breathable. It's loose. Of course, you got the Boost at the bottom.
Can't go wrong.
As I always say, Boost is definitely life for me. Boost is life. Cause I like these. I like the fact that these sneakers are there. They're everywhere.
Yeah.
But subtle at the same time.
Yeah.
So they I could rock these. This shit I got on.
They easy. I like it. And it's ugly. It ain't ugly, but it's such a weird shoe. Like, but it.
Yeah.
It looks so. It's just one piece. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
It's easy to wear. It's easy to put on. You can do anything in a shoe. Chris Brown paints in a shoe.
Yeah.
Like, for real. You can put it on, go to Six Flags, walk around. Yeah. It's comfortable. It's fashionable at the same time. And though, like I said, though it's crazy, it's still subtle and easy to wear. Mm-hmm. I had the butters, but the color couldn't match with anything. So I just ended up selling it because I just have to rock some all black and some. I ain't got nothing that's butter. So, but I definitely have clothes that's black, white, and red, though.
Right on.
So, that's why I'm kind of excited about having this shoe. Next cop, I don't know, man. That 500 for them coppers, that's pretty steep. But I don't know. I might bite the bullet, just bite them things.
Question.
Yeah.
So, I pose this question on Instagram if you follow us. Again, at the sole proprietors. Is Yeezy dead?
No. And even if it is, I don't care. I don't care what's hyped. I don't care what's dead. If I like this, I'm gonna buy it. But the hype has went down, and I don't understand, bro. People weird. If a shoe is not limited, or if everybody doesn't want the shoe, then people say it's dead. It ain't dead, bro. Yeah. It look good. Great, this is a great example. Travis Scott, the collab with the Air Force. You don't see a lot of people rocking Forces much no more. True. Especially outside of Dallas, Texas.
True.
But as soon as Travis Scott did that collab.
Atlanta.
You feel me? As soon as Travis Scott did that collab, they sell out. And it's all just hype, bro. I don't think anything dies.
Well, my opinion?
What shoe died?
I absolutely 100% think Yeezy, the hype on Yeezys are dead, but I have a great reason. I think Yeezys pioneered the lifestyle sneaker to the way they are now. So, and the reason I say they are dead, because there are a lot of more available and cheaper lifestyle sneakers available that may be comparable to Yeezys or better than Yeezys. Per se, an Ultra Boost or a React or Pure Boost or whatever the case may be. There's a lot of lifestyle sneakers that have come into the race to where Yeezy has kind of dropped off. And at the same time, he's kind of mass producing his sneakers as well. Which is
cool.
Fine. That's
cool. Fine. That's another thing.
That's fine.
The whole hype thing. Once you mass produce a shoe, people could assume it died. I don't think it died. I think people still buy the shoe. It's just, it's not a big hype because there's so many. Everybody can get their hands on a pair. Not everybody. Well, a lot more people can get their hands on a pair. So the resale ain't as bad no more. And the hype ain't as bad no more. It ain't gonna sell out in what? It sold out in like 3 seconds once or something like that online.
That ain't gonna
happen no more because there's so many of them.
Yeah.
And which is fine with me because I like the shoe. If that's a problem with it, if you got a problem with that, then you don't like the shoe.
True.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You like the hype around it, which is cool. You know, if you're a hype beast, you're a hype beast. It's whatever. I ain't here to judge, but you know, that's just my opinion on it. I'm gonna buy the shoe.
To me, the hype is dead, but I don't care because I'm still going to purchase them. I still am going to wear them. And I'm going to flaunt the hell out of them. Like, it's my first ever pair. So, I necessarily don't care if the hype is dead or not. But I do think the hype is dead. But
the hype.
In the comments, man. Like we said, comment. Let us know. Are Yeezys dead? Is the hype on Yeezys dead? What do you think? Let us know.
Let us know.
And we'll chop it up with you, man. We really will.
On social media, like we said before. We talk back. Got any questions for us? We talk back.
Mm-hmm.
If we don't get another video out by then, happy Thanksgiving. Be thankful for what you got, because at the end of the day, they just kicks. So, but yeah, man.
Wise words from a wise man.
I'm just going to explain that. I'm just real.
We're going to go ahead and we're going to be out. Thank you guys for watching. Thank you for tuning in. Thank you for everything you do. Peace.
Holla.